So if you recall the separate channels, so we divided the cipher into the message part, the key part, and the part from Nest Wheels. And now we've concluded that if we can, so we're going to try 1,271 possible settings. So for one of those possible settings, we're going to know all the key bits. And that means if we guess the right setting, the key will go to zero. So now all that's left is the other two parts. So this is what we had before. We knew that the probability of delta M being zero was greater than half, and it was actually about 0.61 for German because of the likelihood of message letters being repeated. And we knew that the probability of delta S being zero was about 0.73, and that's because of the structure of the machine, that the S wheels don't advance every step, only when the M wheels are on a one do the S wheels advance. And so now we've said if we guess right, that means the probability that the key bits are zero goes to one. And it'll be one when we guess right. When we don't guess right, it'll be 1/2. So in order to tell if we guess right, well, we need to know that the probability of the ciphertext bits when we guess right, the probability of the delta Z's being zero will be different from 1/2. So the question is, what is the probability delta Z is zero when we guess right? And remember that what delta Z is the XOR of delta M, delta K, and delta S. So to solve this, you need to think about all the different things that would make delta Z equal to zero and compute their probability.